Hey guys, welcome. This is a general reading for the collective of all zodiac signs. Doesn't matter because it's a new moon in Virgo reading. So I'm going to start with the oracle for sacred traveler, and then I'm going to move into an explanation of all the astrology surrounding this new moon in Virgo, and then I'm going to move on to an abbreviated Celtic cross. And then I will head into the extended. The link will be below for that. And I will go through mini readings for each zodiac sign. So that's the whole shebang. This reading is timestamped, so you can move to whatever portion you so desire. Before I pull the oracle, yesterday I did the September 2024 Love Tarot Monthly Energy Update, like I always do. And I got through the YouTube portion of the reading and was about to do the extended. And we've been having a lot of local, like low system storms. No, not really rain productive, but loud clapping thunder, big bolts of lightning. And it seems like it's been hanging, like, you know how you, I have a cloud over my head, literally over my head. And there was a very nearby lightning strike that was so loud and so close that I could literally feel the, you know how you get a twinge on your skin. But it knocked out my internet, although only momentarily, but then the power surge went through my whole house. So knocked out a lot of power, blew out my cable. So I had no choice but to call my cable company, and they were required to come here on an emergency basis, replaced a lot of equipment. And so by the time that was all said and done, I was not in any frame of mind to work with energy and do a proper reading. So I just got done doing that extended. It is now available over there for that September reading. So if you really want to grab that, it's there, it's good. I go through all the zodiac signs for the monthly energy updates as well. If you are in any of the memberships for any of the individuals or for the all access pass, go to moments.com, log into your account, it's there. And thank you for your patience. These things happen. All right, moving on. Sacred Traveler, where have we been? Okay, where are we? Yes, where are we headed? All right, messages are pretty interesting. So where we've just come from, take a risk, venture forward, like that great adventure message. Where are we now? A fresh new way of living emerges, transformation. This feels very powerful. We'll get to that in a second. And then where are we headed? Wandering path, enjoy the journey. So if a fresh new way of living emerges, and then it's telling us there's, so the path may take twists and turns, enjoy the journey. Okay. But you know, where we've come from, it's about venturing forward, taking risks. Life is a great adventure, and it is about growth, change, and transformation. And it feels like we've just come through quite a powerful lunar cycle, the last one being very bumpy. And maybe a lot of us got a little nauseous and seasick, and we were kind of like, get me on dry land. I am not interested in being on this freaking boat anymore. Thank you very much. This is not what I signed up for. And so I'm going to stick with my map and solid ground. Okay, it happens. This lunar cycle, because we're heading into eclipse season, some bumps perhaps, but different. And so I'm going to explain that to you now. So what I do, for those of you who are new, welcome. And I hope if you enjoy this, if this is something you've never seen before, or you really, you know, feel that it's helpful, that it's enlightening, and you haven't yet, please do subscribe below. That's how I grow this channel. And I really do appreciate it when you do that. That's really my biggest ask. Doesn't cost you a thing. It's just a good energetic exchange. That is my ask. So please do help a girl out. But what I do here is I go to my favorite astrologers, most of whom are not out there making memes and stuff. They're not, you know, astrologers to the stars. They are my preferred specialists. And I curate all this information and then I kind of put it into notes, and then I read off my notes because I can't hold it all in my memory. But I make it so that you understand it. Here is what you need to know. Most important points. The new moon will be happening at its peak at 11 degrees of the sign of Virgo. So you want to go to your natal chart and find 11 degrees of Virgo. Doesn't matter if there are any planets there or not. What you're looking for is what house does that land in, because it sort of tells you the area of life that this new moon may be impacting most of all. And it's taking place on the 2nd, which is today as I'm recording this, but later on, so 9:55 p.m. Eastern time, that's like 6:55 on the West Coast, and it will be September 3rd across the pond and other points around the globe, so check your local listings. Virgo is the mansion of precision, of details, perfection, right? Daily routines, our health, all the ways we heal, processes, right? How we come into a more integrated experience of being alive and in a body. And this new moon allows us to kind of dial in our intentions to operate in a more masterful way. Perhaps that word masterful is specific to the magician card, right? The magician is masterful. So especially when it comes to our day-to-day choices. So choices has, to me, a flavor of karma, right? That's what karma is. Karma is the result of our choices. So when you're setting intentions to be more masterful when it comes to your day-to-day choices, be specific, set at least a couple intentions for your choices around your health, mind, body, spirit, okay? Choices around your communication, because we are Mercury, Virgo is Mercury ruled. Choices around healing, because Virgo is also Chiron ruled. And so Virgo is also where we understand being of service. That's probably the only aspect that I master. I am a Virgo sun, that's why I keep saying we. Right? That's where I feel really comfortable. That's why I come here every day and I do this. And it is where I feel masterful. And that co-rulership, like I said, Mercury and Chiron, Virgo, where we're not only communicating more precisely, but we also move through deep healing every time we move through a Virgo new moon. Now, if you are not living under a rock, you know that Mercury has just come through retrograde and has traversed both Virgo, moved back into Leo, turned around, and is now wrapping up that final direct phase, going back to where he first turned around. So there may have been some powerful healing as part of Mercury's backward journey. And the cleaner consciousness is now ready to be folded back into our consciousness in this next lunar cycle. So what that's telling you is we're coming into this new lunar cycle a little stronger, okay? A little less fragile. We've been through the worst of it. We're getting our sea legs back, okay, for those of you who said, okay, that was a nice adventure. I took a risk, I ventured forward. I learned that I don't like the big boat. I'm getting back on dry land. Okay, but at least you did it, you ventured. And so this new moon is not an eclipse, but it does initiate the lunar cycle that includes a full moon eclipse, partial, in 2 weeks from now. Full moon in Pisces, partial eclipse. And so in some ways, the amplified energy of that eclipse season starts with this lunation. Now that's going to be a south node eclipse, and let me explain that because it's kind of important. Meaning the sun will be aligning with the south node. The nodes of the moon are what creates eclipses, as opposed to the north node. The south node is about the past, right? And releasing what no longer serves us. So this full moon up ahead will initiate an epic dump of past patterns and unconscious impulses that are ready to be released. Ready or not, here it comes. Okay, so I would suggest using this new moon as an opportunity to consciously, now that we're back on dry land, consciously set intentions for releasing what's no longer serving you, mind, body, spirit, especially those things that are interfering with like your day-to-day flow. Okay? What are you giving time to from the past that is taking away from all the hopes and dreams you've ever had and keeping you from moving forward? Okay? So, beginning with this new moon, even though it's not part of the eclipse, it kind of is. It's, let's say it's like the starting gate. We can quite literally be walking a new walk when this lunar cycle is over, but it starts with the intentions we are setting now. Focus on whatever needs healing at this time, and you cannot go wrong. But you're going to want to be careful what you wish for, because with all healings, there's often pain at the start. The first thing a surgeon does in order to bring you to perfect health is they cut you open. Sorry. Maybe I should put a little trigger warning. You can't heal old wounds without experiencing them again, even though in a different way. And when the power of love and transformation is poured onto the past, right? We've got this transformation card. That's why I said this was going to be important. This is Phoenix rising. Okay, when the power of love and transformation, I'm saying that again for a reason, is poured onto the past, the part of you that is stuck there can return to your current consciousness in the present. Yeah. And that's where the pain comes back in. So living a consciously embodied life is not for the faint of heart, but the benefits are beyond words. Okay? And you will be best served by enjoying the journey. The path is a little meandering, a little wandering. There are some hairpin turns up ahead, but you're not going to want to miss it. You're not going to want to have your head down in your phone. You're going to want to be watching it all unfold, because life is pretty miraculous. And this lunar cycle has some really beautiful experiences that await us. The Virgo Pisces polarity, that axis, is so powerful and so beautiful. It's not to be missed. Okay? So, that's it. Let's jump into some tarot. A little bit of a modified Celtic cross just to kind of get us in the energy. I'll complete some stuff for you in the extended. Here we go. Yeah, I am really looking forward to this new moon because I've got some routines to get back on. And even I am looking forward to the full moon eclipse because I got some past to let go of. Rivers of tears will be involved. Okay. Ooh, look at that. We open up with the Fool. That is Uranus. Some twists and turns. What's crossing us? Page of Swords, okay. This is a look before you leap. Get some info, do your due diligence. Nine of Swords, but we're worried, we're anxious, we're nervous. Got a little agita, as my grandmother used to say. In the past, magician. Ooh, we've been manifesting something. Seven of Pentacles in our conscious awareness. some awareness of all that lies beneath the surface is where the magic happens. Patience and the Queen of Wands. Okay, some sense of personal power. Our magic. Let me just go ahead and clarify. Fool, Page of Swords. Six of Swords, Hierophant, Lovers. Wow, look before. So there's some curiosity. I'm just gonna hold it like this for a second so you remember that's how it goes, right? We're coming in with the Fool. The fool is the planet Uranus, which is part of this lunation. I didn't talk about it because it's, Uranus has just, is involved in this lunation, but it's more about the collective, the bigger collective. It's not necessarily hitting us in a real personal way, but it's showing up in this reading. So it's the unexpected plot twist, right? And the Page of Swords crossing us is about, you know, do I have the details? What do we need to know here so that I'm maybe prepared for the unexpected? The Fool is also calculated risks. Sometimes it's just a leap of faith. And what I'm looking at here in the clarifiers is the Six of Swords is sort of about getting past something that may have been troubling, right? That may have caused some discombobulation. Oh, I've got something itching me. The Hierophant, and then underneath is the Lovers. The Hierophant does talk about conventional committed relationships. The Lovers is a card of choice. Choosing this soul bond, choosing this connection of free will. So there may be something here where it's like, well, I don't want to be sitting here doubting. I don't want to be sitting here, you know, this can be the spy or detective of the tarot. And sometimes that Page of Swords is looking for like the needle in the haystack or looking for some fine point or detail. And it's almost like you can find trouble if you're looking, if you're splitting hairs, if you're looking close enough and you want to find trouble, you can find it. Does that make sense? Like I'm almost feeling here like you're kind of at that point where you're aware that maybe if you don't go looking for trouble, you won't find it. And what's crossing you here is some, you know, curiosity killed the cat. Yeah, maybe I just need to go with my intuition. Maybe I just need to move forward and follow my heart, and follow my instinct and my intuition, where it leads me to something more peaceful and calm, where this connection is concerned. The Hierophant also talks about our higher self. This is not about our higher self, the Page of Swords. It's not a bad card, but as it is crossing us, it's telling us that it's something that's creating a challenge, if not a block. It's like we're looking for information that may not even exist. It's holding us back in some way. Nine of Swords, and I'm saying that for a reason, because Nine of Swords in unconscious awareness is worry, is a little bit obsessed adjacent. It's something that's running on a loop. It's keeping us up at night. It can be almost a little bit of perseveration. We get something in our head and we just plays on a loop and we can't sleep. Nine of Swords. Eight of Wands, Empress, Seven of Wands. So I think you're worried. Maybe resisting a conversation. Empress is there. Empress is normally coming from some kind of open and receptive energy, and I feel she's kind of coming through reverse, like you're not really receptive. You're very worried about what might be said, what you might hear. That's what you're afraid of. That's why this Page of Swords is problematic. What you might hear, what you might learn. Magician in the past. So we had the Magician, the Tower, the Four of Pentacles, and underneath was the Ace of Pentacles. And this is exactly what happened in the last lunar cycle. All our manifestation brought in something that was either unsustainable or that completely fell apart or blew up in our faces and sent us back into retreat like Danger Will Robinson. And everybody, we all, like, this was a collective experience. I saw it on all the readings. Shut down, heart chakra shut down. Thought we were going to have a new beginning. Nope. Thought offers were coming in. Nope. And what did that tell us about how masterful we were? It sent us a message like, girl. Sent us into lots of panic, lots of Eight of Swords energy, overthinking, second guessing. I can't have nice things. I did not have a good read on this situation. Saw it in almost all of the Lionsgate private readings that I did, and I did many, many, many. So I am here to tell you, you were not alone. It was across the board, all signs. Lots of people touching the iron and getting burned. So now I'm seeing what's happening here. But that was then and this is now. That was then. Not such a great adventure. And then we have now this fresh new way of living emerges. We are transformed. We rise again. Let's see the Seven of Pentacles. Oh, I'm gonna pull for the Queen of Wands too. So beautiful, okay. So, just because, I mean, like I said, it's choices. And I like that this new moon, we're talking about some choices in, you know, the day-to-day realm. And that can be in all the Virgo mansion themes that I spoke of, but it can also be in relationships. And we have evidence that maybe we made some choices that weren't so masterful. And we got some negative karma as evidence. That's the evidence. Those are the receipts. That was not the best choice for me. That's karma teaching us, saying, okay, got to get back on the path. Little ducky, out of the line, get back on your path. And then we make another choice. And then we can have good karma. And good karma says, there you go. Now you're operating at full tilt. So that's what this new moon gives you a new opportunity for. And the Seven of Pentacles is very beautiful energy because look at you, nurture. You're planting these seeds of intention and understanding that the day you plant those seeds is not the day the whole garden grows, right? This card is so perfect at illustrating that. Tenderly nurturing what the little sprouts that pop up and understanding that everything that's important is happening in the fertile soil below. And shit takes time. It takes time, okay? And so there is what you're looking at in the past. And remember I said that full moon coming up is gonna make sure you get rid of all of this. And it isn't gonna be pretty. So you're looking at, this is your last opportunity. Get a good look because you're not gonna be able to stay in Five of Cups land much longer if this is what you truly want. Knight of Cups and the Sun. This love, this offer from the heart, the happiness that it brings. Look at these two looking at each other. Okay? So yes, it takes time. Do your lamenting while you can because you got 2 weeks, my friends. This is what you're manifesting. This is what you're planting seeds of intention to manifest. So you have to believe from your mind that you are worthy with your heart of this, of that kind of happiness. You can't be crying over what you didn't get, what you didn't manifest, okay? Because look what's right behind you, Two of Cups, that beautiful connection. And look where it is in the future. Whoops, I know I'm getting so verklempt. There it is, in time. It unfolds organically, but it's available to you. Queen of Wands, and there's the Hermit. Now, you might say, well, the Hermit, that's kind of weird that the Hermit would be there. No, because the Hermit isn't just about going off on your own and all. It's about growth. It's about personal growth. It's about the transformation too. It's about, you know, coming in. Where was it? Oh, it's not here. It's about coming in off the grid. Reclaiming your power. You're wiser now. You're smarter now. This is in the near future, remember, right? And what do you gain from all of that? Your passion is back. You get your groove back and you understand it took time. You had your own lessons to learn. And so did they. And so this time your manifestation process works like a charm because you did your work. Nice. That's what I have for you. I'm going to give you the astrology that showed up here. And then, of course, down in the description box is a link to the extended. And I go all the way around the zodiac. I group it by element. And I do little mini readings for each one. So if you want a deeper dive, and those are good for Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, for you and your divine counterpart, if you know all those placements, potentially up to 8 mini readings, just FYI. Okay, so we have the Fool is the planet Uranus, which rules Aquarius. We've got the Hierophant, which is Taurus. The Lovers is Gemini. Empress is Venus, which rules Taurus and Libra. Magician, Mercury, Virgo, and Gemini. Tower is Mars, which rules Aries. Knight of Cups, the lovely Pisces. Sun is the Sun, rules the sign of Leo. Queen of Wands is Aries. Hermit is Virgo. That is what I have for you, my loves. New moon blessings to all, and I will head to the extended now. I'll see you there in a second. Bye for now.